changing to now the LMIA can be a little bit daunting for a lot of employers or applicants out there. If you really look at it compared to the previous labor market opinion, they're very similar, except the LMIA process does have extra requirements. So for the LMI application, we do have a step-by-step checklist that we provide clients that retain the firm. But part of this video is really to go over that checklist a little bit. For the LMIA application, there are a few documents that are essential to be included in every application. So I'll just read some of them out to you. The first are obviously the forms. Those are mandatory. For those of you who've seen or reviewed those forms, they can be extremely intimidating. There's a bunch of questions asked from the employer as well as the applicant that you may or may not know how to answer. So if you need assistance in completing the forms, do give us a call. So there's the LMIA application form. There's the Schedule A, Schedule B, Schedule C, and Schedule E form. Each of these forms are quite lengthy, especially the actual LMIA application. Also, the other thing you have to remember is that the application is divided into high-skilled and low-skilled, and you want to make sure that you're skilled. So based on your skill, you file the necessary application form. If you file the wrong form, so let's say your application or your skills are considered high skilled and you accidentally complete the low skilled form, your application will be returned to you and you just wasted processing time. So look at the NOC, look at the matrix and see if your NOC is under the high skilled or the low skilled. And based on that, make sure you complete the necessary forms. So after you have all the forms, you have to include also proof of your recruiting efforts. There's, for most occupations, there's a minimum of 2 recruiting efforts you have to do, and you have to demonstrate that, so copies of that. The recruitment efforts have to be for a minimum of 4 weeks, so make sure you have those details out and copies of that in your application. The other one, which is very important, is business documentation. So business registration, T4s, articles of incorporation, anything that demonstrates to the Service Canada officer that this is a operating legitimate business in Canada. So some of the things you can prove is the business registration, the legal corporation or incorporated documents, Canada Revenue Agency, so the CRA documents. You can include Schedule 100 and 125 of the T2 corporate income tax. There's the T2 125 statements if you're a sole practitioner, sole proprietorship documents. So there's a bunch of documents depending on which province your corporation or your company is registered, how you practice, or if it's a partnership, incorporation, sole proprietorship, so those documents. And also your CRA, your tax documents. These are the 3 main things that you can include to demonstrate it's a legitimate operating business in Canada. Also, depending on the province, certain provinces and certain companies require that province's licensing. So you want to make sure you have copies of licensing authorizing you to practice in that province. Also, just to name a few, so for example, for Manitoba, there's a certificate of registration that need to be included. For the province of Alberta, for example, the employment agency business license needs to be included. And so certain provinces have certain extra requirements. You want to make sure you look into that before you submit the application. In addition to the corporate documentation, you obviously want to include documents about the actual foreign candidate that you've chosen. So their credentials, their resume, their copy of their passport data page. So credentials and their identity documents. And you know, outline why the Canadian citizens and permanent residents who applied, you did not like them, you did not hire them, and compare it to the foreign national that you would like to hire. What makes this individual stand out? Why do you choose this individual? So not only explain that in a thorough submission or cover letter, but also include evidence in regards to that, your reasoning. So if your reasoning is that the candidate has far more work experience that you like, include copies of previous employment reference letters to prove that this employee has those credentials and experience that you prefer over the Canadian or permanent residence. So those are the essential documents that you want to include in every labour market impact assessment application. There's far more other documents, unfortunately. You know, compared to the LMO, it's a little bit more intense. There's more documents required. It's what Service Canada wants. And so if if you need a detailed document checklist, give us a call. Let us make sure that you have all the documents in order before you submit your application. If you have any questions about the LMIA process or the list of documents, give us a call. We're here to help. Thank you, and until next time.